Good evening. Today we are blessed to have the Honorable Simon Akecha, who is the NUP candidate for Omoro by elections. We want to find out his decision to abandon FDC for NUP.
NUP is the one now holding the serving spoon for opposition. A best player like me, I cannot be sold to a second team like FDC, third team like DP, or a fourth team like UPC.
Simon Tolit Akecha has a six-point program for the people of Omoro County. It covers health, infrastructure, and clean water, education, and agriculture, among others. He claims to have been the first member of parliament to purchase an ambulance for his constituents in 2008. And he believes that he deserves the Omoro County sympathy vote more than anyone else.
If at all they are supposed to give sympathy vote, then I'm the first to get the sympathy vote, because the father robbed me in 2016 and made me not to complete my program. The people of Omoro cried because we were the majority.
The senior consultant in tax and administration worked for the Uganda Revenue Authority for 14 years. Simon Tolit Akecha is widely expected to become the biggest opponent to the NRM chosen flag bearer, Ojok Andrew Olanya, to replace the late Speaker of Parliament Jacob Olanya as the Omoro County MP in the 11th Parliament. He strongly believes that it is a new beginning for the people of Omoro County under his leadership and the guidance of the NUP Party.
How welcome is the NUP Party in Omoro County? And just not just Omoro, beyond Omoro, how widespread is NUP?
For me, I joined politics in 2005 as the chairman of the FDC group. So I know how to mobilize people. And for your information, all the three elections, the one of 2006, I won Olanya, I was in parliament. Even the one of 2011, I won. And then, as I told you, the 2016, it was the worst. They claim I lost, but you know, will never declare without figures. So, with that experience, I told you I'm the best player.
In the 2006 general elections, Simon Tolit Akecha defeated the then incumbent Jacob Olanya for Omoro County. And after a brutal campaign, the two again exchanged the seat in 2011. To date, he still believes that he was the rightful winner of the 2016 general elections against Jacob Olanya. Simon Tolit Akecha is also not satisfied with the achievements of former Speaker of Parliament Jacob Olanya for Omoro County.
10 years. Why did he do it when he was there as Deputy Speaker? For 10 years. Why should he negotiate for the road at this time? So the sympathy vote can only go to me, who, with my people, who were up in 2016, where the Deputy Speaker was declared without figures.
The 61-year-old veteran politician has put the health of his people at the heart of his manifesto.
Well, in terms of Omoro County, the Honorable Simon Tolit Akecha is a legend. And we just want to find out now, what exactly does he have for the people of Omoro in the next 4 years? Actually, maybe 3 years, since the elections are on the 26th of May 2022. Just give us briefly your program now. What do you have for the people of Omoro?
For women who are pregnant, who want to go and deliver, from maybe the Cho Hospital or independent hospital where they charge, they will get it free. We have an organization which is catering for.
And speaking about the uproar that arose against the NUP for allegedly organizing a demonstration at a time when the late Speaker of Parliament was undergoing treatment in the USA, Simon Tolit Akecha says the people were demonstrating against the huge expenditure, but not the sick person of the Speaker.
When he was leaving for US, he knew he was not coming back alive. And he told the father. And that's why the father is still insisting up to now that my son is what? Because he told him. So that is not an issue. That demonstration was on the... Those people were demonstrating against the expenditure. Okay? Why rush with somebody at the last minute if you want to save his life?
Simon Tolit Akecha is confident that his vote cannot be rigged during the Omoro County by-election.
If NRM, I must repeat to them, has elected somebody who is capable, like Engineer Olal, Ben Achela, I wouldn't have actually accepted even in Noob. I said, we are just going for friction for nothing. I think this candidate can complete the term, and we see 2026.
Thank you so much for this interview, and we wish you the very best.
Thank you.
All right. The casting of the vote for Omoro County by-election is scheduled for the 26th of May 2022. And in the next few days, on the 12th to the 13th of May, the candidates are expected to go and pick their nomination cards by the Independent Electoral Commission. My name is Joseph Omagor for the news in Omoro District.